Hello and welcome to another CF Power Script tutorial with me, Christian Rauchenwald. Now in this video, I'm going to show you how you can set up the CF Pretty Products Power Script to do things like add product images to your product selectors in ClickFunnels, or pre-select the product, or highlight a specific product, and much more. As always, in order to get started, you will need to log into your CF Power Scripts account. And once you're there, from the dashboard, head to the Power Script section. Now this is a Power Script specifically made for the order form page, so you will need to pick your funnel and within your funnel pick your order form. I'm going to show you how you can add it to a regular order form and to a two-step order form, and we're going to start with the regular order form, so I'm going to pick that one here in my development funnel. Now if you're running a split test in ClickFunnels, you can either add the script here to the step so it will be active in the control and the variation page, or you could add it to the page specifically by clicking on the page and then adding the script there. This would allow you to split test different product highlights, so using different colors, different texts, or highlighting different products to see which one actually performs better. For the purpose of this demo, I'm just going to add it straight here, and I'm going to click on Add New and look for the Pretty Products Power Script. As you can see, there are a ton of settings that we need to fill in here, starting with the product ID. So I'm also going to open ClickFunnels, and in ClickFunnels, I'm going to my funnels and I'm going to select my development funnel. Now within the funnel, I'm going to the order form page that I also selected in CF Power Script, and I'm going to head to the product section. As you can see here, this funnel step has a total of 6 products, 3 main products, and 3 that are meant as order bumps. And for the purpose of this demo, we are going to highlight the payment plan product. So I'm just going to right click the edit button and select copy link address. As an alternative, you could also just click on edit and then from the URL copy the product ID. It's in the URL, you have funnel steps followed by the step ID slash products, and then that number here is the product ID. But again, you can copy the entire URL as well, head back to CF Power Scripts, paste the URL into the product ID field and click somewhere else and it will extract the product ID. Now there are some settings here that you will see later once we actually set the script up, so you'll know what they do. For now, I'm going to select centered here, and I'm going to select yes here so that the highlighted product, which is our payment plan, should also be automatically pre-selected. There are a bunch of color settings that we are currently going to ignore, and I'm going to show you how they work and what they affect later again. And then there is a table where we can add additional product information, and we're going to do this for our main product, so for our first 3 products. Now our second product was the payment plan, so again I'm going to paste the URL, which I still have in my clipboard, in there to get the product ID from the payment plan, and I'm going to go back and I'm going to copy the URLs for the first product, which is a subscription product, paste it in here to have the product ID, and also for the third product, which is a one-time purchase, and again paste it in here. Now it doesn't matter in which order you do that, so they don't have to be in the same order like in ClickFunnels. It just matters that those product IDs actually exist on the funnel. Now here I'm just going to write something like save 15%. Here I'm going to write only today, and here we're actually going to write nothing, so I'm going to leave that empty. And as old price, I'm going to add $97 here, $999 here, and $12 here. And with that, we just click on Add Script, and we're good to go. Now, when I open that funnel step by clicking on the shortcut icon and clicking on Open Live Funnel Step, we can see that it changes the layout and that it adds the additional text where we defined it. So for the first 2 products, it added the save 15% and the only today text. For the third product, it didn't do that because we didn't define anything. Additionally, it also added the old prices to the products here, so people see the old price, and we have a highlighted product. Now there are a bunch of different colors, and we're gonna quickly click on edit in CF Power Scripts so you see which color actually goes where. So we have our default border color, and in the funnel, you can see that's the color around the products themselves, followed by the highlight product color, which is the color that you currently cannot see because this product is also selected. But if I select a different product, you can see that the highlighted product actually has a different color set. You could set both of them to the same color, so you could set both of them to red, for example, or use different colors like I'm doing in this example. It's totally up to you. Now, additionally, we also have, as mentioned, the selected product color, which currently is set to yellow. So as you see, whichever product is selected is changed to yellow. And last but not least, we have the text color for the product add-on text, which is set to red here, and we have the text color for the old price, as you can see here. But that's not all that you can do with this power script. If we go into ClickFunnels and here for this funnel step, I go to overview and edit the page in the page editor. And I'm going to add a new image element somewhere on the page, preferably somewhere down so that people don't see it appear and disappear when it's used. And by selecting the image element here, clicking on it and selecting some image from our library. And I'm just gonna pick this picture here for starters by clicking on it twice. Now I need a product ID again, so let's take the first product ID, or let's take the one of the highlighted product. Now we can simply click on the product, and the first thing we'll need to do is we'll need to disable the lazy loading for this image, so set lazy loading to false, and then go down to the hashtag icon where it says get CSS info and change the title to product minus img for image minus the actual product ID, so the product ID that we copied. Click on update, click on save, and then simply go and refresh your funnel step. And as you can see, the image that we added now disappeared from down here, so it's not where we added it, but it actually got moved into the product selector. And you can do this for all the products on your funnel. You simply have to add one image element per product and disable lazy loading, and then change the CSS title to product minus img minus the product ID. But that's still not all that you can do with the CF Pretty Products power script. As you notice, we have our text here, best deal, and our recommended text. And in the power script, you can see that they are configured here. Now for the label that gets added on top of the product, on regular order forms, you can choose where it should be positioned. So you can say it should be inward, and we're gonna update this and simply refresh the funnel step. And you can see that it now is inside the product itself. That only makes sense if you don't use the add-on text, as you can see, because it might overlap depending on the width of your order form. Or as an alternative, you can also change it to outward, which is the exact opposite. So when we save that and go back to the funnel and refresh the funnel step, you can see that it's now added on top. Last but not least, for both of those settings, so for the top label and for the bottom label, you can also decide to leave them out. When you leave this field here empty and you click on save, and we go back and we refresh the page, you can see that it just adds the bottom recommended text. And again, that text is totally up to you, so you can enter whatever you want. And the same applies to the bottom text, so you could theoretically leave both of them empty. Simply click save. And as you can see, the bottom edition now also disappeared. I also want to point out here that for the top label, if you have a graphic prepared that says something like best deals or something similar, you could also use that, but it would require some custom CSS. And also, as you saw during the demo, depending on your setting, if you set the top label to top, bottom, or centered, it may not be perfectly aligned. That depends on the other CSS on your funnel step and some other factors. If you have any issues with the alignment of texts or that label, simply use the contact button in the bottom right corner within CF Power Scripts and reach out to us. And we are going to look at your funnel and provide you with the custom CSS needed to actually get things looking the way they should. But in most cases, the default settings should already be sufficient. Now with that, let's take a quick look how the same power script looks on a two-step order form. For that, I'm going to go back to CF Power Scripts and I'm going to my two-step order form funnel step. And I'm going to use the shortcut from here to open it in ClickFunnels, since we again are going to need the product IDs. I'm going to close the additional tabs. Here we are heading to the products tab, and in CF Power Scripts, I'm going to click add new. Again, look for the pretty products power script. And we again are going to highlight our payment plan by copying the link address from the edit button, heading back, pasting that in there, clicking somewhere else, and continuing with the rest of the settings. I also need to point out that when you're using a two-step order form, the setting that places the top label only supports outward. So if you select inward or centered, it will not make a difference. That's because the two-step order form, or the product selector within the two-step order form, uses a different HTML structure, and there it simply was not possible for us in an easy way or in an easy fashion to place or manipulate the placement according to that setting. But that shouldn't be a big issue, so we're going to set that to outward. We again are going to say we want to pre-select the product, and we're going to add a product price and an additional tag. Again, we're going to say save 15% here, and the old price, let's say 997. I'm going to click on add script, And again, before we actually look at the funnel, I'm gonna go and edit the funnel and also add a product image. So I'm gonna get the product ID again from our highlighted product, go into the funnel and add a new image element, click on that image element, disable lazy loading, select a graphic from our image library. I think I'm gonna go with the same one again and change the CSS title to product minus image minus the product ID, update, save the changes, and then simply from CF Power Scripts, go and open the live funnel step by using the shortcut. And here, when we scroll down, we see our two-step order form, and I'm using my shortcut here to skip ahead. And as you can see, it works in exact the same fashion. Again, we have different colors. For the product where we configured it, we have the additional text, we have the old price, and we have our product image here. So that's pretty much it. That's how easy you can improve the look and feel of your order forms product selection in ClickFunnels thanks to our CF Pretty Products Power Script to make it easier for your customers to select the product they want or to highlight the product that you think most users should buy. Maybe highlight the product at a higher price point that offers a bigger discount or something like that. Now, the last thing I want to mention here is when it comes to your product images, make sure that you use them in the proper size. As you saw during the demo, the product image is only visible very small, so you should create your product image roughly in 50 by 50 or 100 by 100 pixels dimension. They shouldn't be much bigger than that because it will only mean that users will have to download a bigger image that at the end will only be displayed very small. So make sure to scale your images properly so you don't have any negative impact on your funnel's loading times thanks to your product images. Now, as always, thanks for watching, and even more so, thanks for using CF Power Scripts. See you in one of our other tutorials. Till then, bye-bye.